as well, especially in dealing with large units. So before we get into the army list here, really very quickly, I'd like to mention that Curse of the Midnight Wind, if you are Bretonians and you have a damsel, if you cast it on a charging unit, whether it be Demigryphs or Blood Knights, what it does is it doesn't take away their charge bonus, but it reduces their attack. So because it reduces their attack and not their weapon damage, it makes it so these guys miss fucking everything. So yeah, they have huge amounts of weapon damage because they have charge, but they will not hit you at all. By the time that their charge bonus is on, Curse of the Midnight Wind will have just barely gone off, and so you will get full effectiveness out of that curse.
Yeah, that's pretty cool. Essentially, you're stripping them of their charge bonus in one way.
Exactly, right? You're stripping them of all attack, and they lose their charge bonus because, yeah, they get the charge bonus, of course, but it only adds to weapon damage, not melee hit chance.
If you don't hit, it doesn't matter.
Exactly. And that's what Curse of the Midnight Wind does for you. I'm going to go over the Bretonian list real quick here. For Saphir, for Zeledi, we have a mainline of six polearms. Six polearms is going to be really effective against the lack of missile units that the vampire counts have. Remains to be seen whether or not they will be able to hold, though, against the terror-causing vampire units. For the range units, very, very classic Bretonian build here, we have six units of peasant bowmen. You know, sometimes a risk to take against the vampire counts, but still, if you give good micro, can prove to be very, very useful. Just got to keep them protected. On the sides here, we have a unit of Grail Knights and a unit of Knights of the Realm, and on the other side, the exact same thing, a unit of Grail Knights and a unit of Knights of the Realm. Leadership, of course, very, very quickly, just Loen Leonqueur on his Hippogriff Becky. And what do we got for Chaos? Oh, sorry, not Chaos, Vampire Counts.
For Vampire Counts, looks like we have some symmetry going, kind of. Well, yeah. Actually, no, because he has an extra Blood Knight on his right flank. So he has two Blood Knights on his right, supporting his general on horseback. I believe that is Manfred. Yes, it is Manfred. We see two Cane Wraiths on the right, two Cane Wraiths on the left, another Blood Knight, so three Blood Knights in total. Very, very nice Scav Force. We see also a bunch of Skeleton Spearmen, four of them, and two Fell Bats. So his melee line is actually not that strong at all. Like, he only has four Cane Wraiths, basically. The Skeleton Spearmen won't really do anything, so... Interesting choices here.
You are quite right there. I mean, you know, the melee lineup for our Vampire Counts player here is next to nothing. He has next to nothing for his melee line. And so, you know, these peasants actually will be able to succeed rather well against these spells and Skeleton Spearmen, even against the Cairn Wraiths, because they will eventually be able to get through those Cairn Wraiths and do the damage that they need to do. And also, it should be interesting to note that instead of using these Cairn Wraiths here on the left flank to support his infantry force to maybe allow a little bit more pressure being put on the Bretonian peasants, he is instead deciding to use them in his cavalry force here to the left-hand side. Honestly, by the way, I'd like to know that that is a very good idea, because two units of Grail Knights and two units of Knights of the Realm will defeat two units of Blood Knights. The third unit of Blood Knight there will probably turn the tide of battle, but the Cairn Wraiths give him the guarantee.
Okay, so he's stopping the bowmen with Fell Bats. That is nice, but he needs to actually engage with his infantry while he's doing that. And his right flank is stationary. He needs to move it, because that's how he's going to win this game. He needs that right flank moving and going.
Precisely.
Not doing anything right now.
The Cairn Wraiths are not doing anything. The Blood Knights are kind of herky-jerky and are not moving here together. Knights of the Realm going to get caught by a charge in the Blood Knights. So instead, going to move back around, maybe try to countercharge with somebody else. Yeah, Knights of the Realm going with a countercharge with Loen Leonke also getting into the battle. Theta Buna, of course, going down the Knights of the Realm to the very right-hand, the very left-hand side. Manfred getting his money back there, going to be able to kill those Knights extremely readily. But the Polearms are now getting into combat with the Blood Knights, and the Polearms are actually incredibly effective against Blood Knights in those battles. For the rest of the fight here, it does look like the line troops are holding all right for the Bretonians, managed to crumble at least this right-hand flank of the Vampire Counts, but is still going to have to try to work on this center and may eventually lose this fight on the left. Luckily, though, Peasant Bowman still around, still here in force, still able to pepper the Blood Knights. Look how much damage they do, even with just one volley there. How do you think this catfight's going to turn out?
That catfight, well, I think it's going to go well for Bretonia, but he has to pull out his general out of there because, like, because he managed to make the Vampire Counts use Nahek, so he should get out of there. Nahek isn't going on anymore, but did heal a lot of the Vampire Counts units. So he has to get out before he loses Luan. He's taking massive damage right now.
He is. Luan is taking serious damage, and he will rout very, very soon. Honestly, it is better that he routes ASAP, because that'll get him out of the fight a little bit faster before he loses too much more health. Also, more charges going in here, down with the Knights of the Realm and the Grail Knights. Of course, Grail Knights continuously getting Fate of Bunid by Manfred there, and making actually a huge difference in that fight. One unit of Blood Knights down, two units of Blood Knights down, only one more unit of Blood Knights to go. Meanwhile, the infantry fight is getting wrapped up. It looks like it's about even for both sides here. The right-hand flank won by Bretonians with little to no losses to their polearms. So as long as we can get Saphir to get his bowmen the hell back and away from these chasing skeleton spearmen, these polearms will very easily be able to intercept and be able to kill this vampire line force. Meanwhile, the cavalry of the vampire, yeah, they killed the cavalry of the Bretonians, but I mean, I don't think their success is going to win them the game, do you?
No, like, look at all those bowmen firing at that massive blob. The thing is, though, the Blood Knights, they did get another Nahek, so they are still alive, but that's gonna be the last charge of those Grail Knights. After that charge, they're dead. They're it pulling is, out, but they won't make it out.
And they did it. I think they did significant enough damage to the Blood Knights there. Did significant enough damage with that charge there. Just keep getting these sacrificial charges in to let at least the Blood Knights crumble, and they will no longer be a problem. If they have 5, 6, even 10 members in their unit, they will still be able to kill all the peasants in the world. And so gotta get those Blood Knights down to at least like 2 or 3 so they crumble on their own.
Blood Knights incoming, they're gonna deal with those peasant bowmen if they don't kite. Ooh, the peasant bowmen gonna get caught here. Nope!
Ooh, they're no, the Luan. Blood Knights making the choice, going for Loen Leonqueur. Will it be worth it? Actually, with the Nahek going off on the Blood Knights, it might be. It might in fact be, because the Blood Knights have regened a little bit of health there, and Manfred also helping out in the fight against Luan, and the Karen Raids coming in. Luan actually is going to be taken down.
Yeah, he's gonna die. That was not a great engagement with Luan. This might cost him the game.
I mean, here, I can kind of understand why he wanted to do that with Luan, right? He wanted to protect his bowmen from that incoming charge that was going to be inevitable from the Blood Knights and from Manfred himself. But Luan just, okay, well, at least he's out of combat now. He has managed to run away from combat, so he will be back to the fight just a little bit later. In the meantime, because Luan is running away, though, we see the kind of mass rout on this side, despite the fact that the infantry over here for Saphir, for the Lady, was a little bit stronger. The cleanup happening now that Loen is running away. Loen is back now. We'll see if this can help out a little bit with the morale problems that the peasants are facing.
Yeah. Oh no, he's engaging again.
He is engaging again.
This is his last engagement, probably.
Don't ever not call Saphir a ballsy motherfucker, man. But this is balls right here, man. This takes true testicular just toughness to do this.
No.
Yeah, it looks like he's going back into it again. He wanted to charge a general, maybe get a lucky charge up, get some serious damage in on Manfred. Doesn't look like that's going to happen, though. Yep. Lucky for Luen, though, is that he runs away very, very quickly, and when he does run away, can actually bulldoze his way through multiple units of troops. And so he's not going to die yet. Actually, Manfred is going to have to cast a spell on him if he wants to end up finishing him off. The archer is doing pretty damn good damage against Manfred with the fire from the top there. And, of course, this infantry fight slowly getting wrapped up. Looks like the Bretonians will eventually win that fight. Do you think the Vampire Counts have enough here to take the game for themselves?
If they have a Spirit Leech for Luan, this game is over, I think. And I think Iron General's Lord is coming for it. I think he's going to do it.
Yeah, I think that's exactly what Manfred's intention is right there. He might also be trying to come in here and help the Blood Knights before they all actually die. Halberdiers, again, very, very effective against the Blood Knights. As the Blood Knights are not necessarily anti-infantry, but actually anti-large. In the meantime, though, this flank getting wrapped up very nicely, and look how many halberdiers and bowmen Saphir of the Lady has left. I think he's got this game in the bag.
Yeah, he's managed to turn it around, because his units kept coming back, which is nice. Like, they were not shattered, so they keep coming back, and the bowmen can keep firing and firing, and while the polearms can just stay in there and make sure that Vampire Counts are busy in engagements while the bowmen shoot, so...
Surely. No, absolutely, man. And it's, you know, one of the nice things about being Bretonians is your units will come back after they rout. And another reason why you do not want to set your Bretonians up on the back line and camp a back line, because they will run away and then not rout like you want them to. In the meantime, it looks like Manfred is looking for that Spirit Leech on Colofrans, chasing around the map. Colofrans, I'm not sure if Colofrans is trying to actively avoid Manfred or has just decided to take out these Karen Raids, and that is why he's over there.
Colofrans.
No, it looks like he's actually... Sorry, Carl Franz, my bad. Good God, somebody shoot me right now.
Empire assisting Bretonnia in this game?
Yeah, dude, you know, the Gondor calls for aid, right? Bretonnia calls for aid. By the way, it does look like Bretonnia is really wrapping this battle up here. Just a few effective units left from our Vampire Counts player. Whereas Arbitonian has a little bit of a larger army and a lot more tools in his toolbox to be able to use against the vampires. Manfred not able to get that final Spirit Leech to end Luwen on him yet, and Luwen, of course, regenerating that health very, very rapidly.
Yeah, so this started out pretty well for Britonia, then Vampire Counts turned it around, and now again it seems like Britonia is taking the lead. So
surely.
It's a very exciting game, let's put it up.
It is, it certainly is. I think this is certainly one of the closer games that we have had, of course. You know, this is where you're really going to see the strength of the Vampire Counts, is in these low unit count battles. The terror that the Vampire Counts cause, as well as the resilience of their units in general with Curse of Nahek and things like this, this ethereal buff that the Karen Wraiths have, makes it very, very hard to kill these types of units in low health battles. And with Manfred in the back and your own general on low health, you do not want to get Lo and Kerr into the battle, as Manfred can easily Spirit Leech and cause all your peasants to run. So, looks like we will be setting up some new lines here, by the way, for Britonia. Wise choice, by the way. Wise choice by Saphir the Lady. Not trying to get too impatient. Knowing that he has this archer advantage over here, has at least two units of archers left. All the other ones have routed off the field. But at least with those two units of archers, he can shut down the morale of the Kraren Wraiths and also keep Manfred away from this main battle while the Halberdiers fight the real one. And Lohenker, I'm sure, drops in and out doing what damage he can.
I mean, we saw Master of the Black Arts popped on the Lord of Vampire Counts, so he might be regenerating some of his magic. Oh, he just overcast.
All right, guys. You know when you don't want to overcast your Invocation of Nahek? You don't want to overcast your Invocation of Nahek when you only have two units of Kraren Wraiths remaining and your Vampire Count General is almost dead. Unfortunately, though, Invocation of Nahek, unfortunately for the Britonian player, Invocation of Nahek actually overcasting gives the Vampire General more health than he started out with. I'm not sure if that's the way it should go.
But he wasted it because he could have had the Spirit Leech on potentially on Britonia. Well, now it won't finish him off, but it might have brought him low enough to finish him off in melee,
at least
perhaps.
To get him to run away. And also, I think the Invocation of Nahek should have been used, if he was going to use it, should have been used while he was approaching combat with the Kraren Wraiths and Manfred, because that extra damage would have been very, very useful to use up against these Halberdiers here. Halberdiers should not have charged there at all. Countercharging with Halberdiers, never a good idea with the Britonians, because the Britonians have charge defense against all, and you have no charge bonus to speak of, so you might as well just stay still and prevent the charge bonus from the Kraren Wraiths from coming in at you.
Yeah. And also, just imagine if we had regular Invocation of Nahek just on his general, then he could have probably still activated the Spirit Leech on the Luwen.
He'd still
have enough mana.
And it would have probably done enough heals to do what he wanted to do with those heals, isn't that right?
Yeah, I think so.
In the meantime, though, it does look like, yeah, you know, some of the Britonians here are losing their morale extremely quickly. They're losing their morale with extreme rapidity. But it is also telling that the Vampire Counts here have lost next to all of their morale. So the Kraren Wraiths will start to crumble very, very soon. It's going to be up to Loen Leonker to really bring in the damage to finish off those Kraren Wraiths.
This was a mistake, engaging the Vampire Counts. Should have just guided and used only his general. But I guess he thought he could finish it here.
Absolutely. Yeah. You know, and I thought too that Halberd line would be able to finally finish off that battle, would be able to finish off the last of the Vampire Counts. Clearly that is not the case, though, as the Kraren Wraiths have managed to chew through the Halberdiers very, very readily. And now this is going to get bad, because the units will shatter if... Oh, nice charge on Manfred, by the way. Here comes the battle. Kraren Wraiths and everybody else up against Loen Leonker. Loen Leonker going to try to skip out of there. This is what we wanted to see with Loen.
Yeah, he's running away. He still has quite the HP, though, so he won't get finished off by a Spirit Leech or something, and he might finish off the wizard.
I think he's going to be able to. These charges are extremely effective. Almost no health on Manfred left. If he doesn't die now, something is very, very wrong with this game. Gonna take another hit there. Manfred crumbling. How much health does the man have? The man has 141 health. We'll be crumbling very, very shortly. But in the meantime, we'll try to at least run down some of these Britonian units. Coming back, not crumbling anymore for Manfred. Think he's gonna live through this, or Leonko's gonna be able to catch him?
He's gonna die. I don't think he has enough for another invocation.
I don't believe so either, but honestly, Leonka has got to get in here and get the job done quickly, because he... Oh, nice.
There we go.
Great hit. It looks like Leonka kind of just hopped down briefly, kind of had a high five with Manfred right to the nuts. Manfred going down, and now the Vampire Count's army crumbling like we expect them to, with a Vampire General dead.
Ooh, this was extremely close.
Yes, this is as close as they get, ladies and gentlemen, as close as they get. I'm going to point you towards something right now. If these Karen raids kill these two units from Bretonnia here, it is very likely that the entire Bretonnian army will shatter and rout. So
they're crumbling.
They are crumbling. So it is really up to Leonker here to keep running away with these foot troops so they don't get caught by the Karen Rays and allow Leonker to get that hit and run damage in on the Karen Rays as soon as possible. Absolutely, yeah, dude. Booped right in the private bits, man. Right in the Ghibli bits, the Gribbly bits. Is what Leonker is good at, man. Just a fistful of talon. Beautiful stuff, beautiful stuff. Karen Raids, of course, you know, they are going to be able to finally catch these halberdiers. Leonker trying his best to engage these Karen Raids so that they do not catch any of these other units. But the micro, considering that right now Iron General only has two units of micro, he is very, very on top of his Karen Raids chasing the wrong units. So he's making sure that whenever Leonker gets into combat, his Karen Raids are still chasing peasants around.
Yeah, but he's not going to finish Luan. He can't. And even if he routes that peasant bowman, which he did, it's still not going to matter because Luan is still going to be on the field.
But yep, it does look like it. You know, my prediction that the peasant army would shatter with those last two units dying did not come true. And it looks like, in fact, the Bretonnians will be able to hold due to their last two units over here. Those two halberdiers holding out with just a little less than half morale. Did Luan get healed, by the way, Demicor? Yeah, he has passive regen. Arbo, thank you for that. Arbo, you know, splitting up the Cairns, he could certainly have done that. I'm not sure exactly what that would have done for him outside of making it more hard for Luan to engage. Do you think that he should have split up those Karn raids to TPP?
It's hard to call because if he split them up, then Luan can definitely kill one of them very easily. So,
sure.
And then the Bretonnian player could just kite away with the other infantry. So if he split them, then one of them would just get singled out and we'd have the same result probably.
Yeah, absolutely, absolutely. Yeah, you know, that's I think that's about true as well. I think the Karn Rays are a little bit more effective in this group here just because they cannot get singled out by Loenka like they would be, like you said, if those guys are alone. In the meantime, in before draw, there ain't gonna be no draw here, motherfucker. What are these halberdiers doing? I am not sure.
No.
This is not. If the Karen Rays break these halberdiers,
they're crumbling just before.
Ooh.
And the game is stuck.
Oh, the game is frozen.
Yeah, look. But zoom in. Look at those Karen Rays while crumbling. This is a great pause moment.
Just scattered in the air here. So guys, you know, if you guys wanted to know, Karen Rays actually still have teeth despite the fact that they have lost their gums. They still have teeth. Very interesting indeed. Yeah, dude, GG for the Bretonnian, GG for the ponies. Great game there. My Saphira is the ladies champion. But honestly, damn good game by Iron General there as well. Very, very close. So, you know, Iron General, he lost the game. Do you think you know why that was?
Well, one thing he could have done, which would have definitely won him this game, is if you look at the Bretonnian army, we see only one unit in the air, and that's Luan.
Yeah.
And if we had some Vampire Counts units in the air, this could have looked totally different. Like, if we had a couple Felbats or Vargeist, like, what is... Okay, Leonker is strong, but what is he going to do if he gets swarmed by, like, four or five air units? He's still going to die, and then the game is going to be over.
Yeah.
So, I think Saphir was like playing a little bit risky with what he chose here.
Sure.
Because he didn't have like a paladin as well.
As an escort,
Pegasus. Yeah.
I mean, I think to a certain extent, you know, I think Saphir could have been very confident in his peasants being able to protect his flying units if Vampire Counts did come with a lot of flying. But then again, that would also lock Loenker down to just one very, very small area. And we wouldn't be able to harass like we see that he did. I think maybe the reason that I think that Iron General eventually lost this battle was for two large reasons here. I think Manfred should have been more aggressive with the lore of vampire spells instead of the lore of death spells. Fate Abuna is very good on the Grail Knights, don't get me wrong, but I think it would have been better used if he had, for example, Wind of Death, the peasants, or Invocation of Nehecht, more of his guys, or even used Gaze of Nagash instead of Spirit Leech, which has proven to be not nearly as effective on Loenke. And then, of course, the Blood Knights. I don't think the Blood Knights were used particularly effectively.
No.
Sure. You cleaned up most of the cav out of the Bretonnians, but then you lost three Blood Knights for four Bretonnian cav units. Not quite worth the money there, I don't think, especially when you're taking a line as weak as the Vampire mainline was this game.
Yeah, the 26 kills Blood Knight unit. It was the one that got singled out by Lewin and like a polearm and some cav, I think. That was way out of support range.
Hardly worth. You know, another thing that I would, of course, like to note. You know, I like to note things, guys. I have these things written down. I have actually a pad of paper in front of me now, and writing things down. Silly as hell. Oh, also, by the way, guess what, guys?
Oh, you have a GG button now.
Yeah, I got a GG button. anyhow, I got it a long time ago. I finally dug it out of storage from all my other StarCraft stuff. One thing that I would also like to note is that if you are bringing Blood Knights, know that if you have been playing Demigryph Knights for a while, you cannot quite play Blood Knights like the Demigryph Knights. For example, Blood Knights take much more missile fire damage than Demigryph Knights ever will. I'm actually not exactly sure why that is the case, guys. I'm not exactly sure. But I do know that for some, it does seem like archers do a significantly more amount of damage to Blood Knights. I mean, they shave off health and damage, even peasant archers, very, very rapidly. I think it has something to do with unit size, but I'm not sure. You have any ideas, TPP?
No, I actually don't know about this one.
Yeah. Let's go over the army list, shall we?
Yeah, sure, you can go over Bretonnia.
Alrighty, as per usual, my favorite here. So we got Bretonnia here, bringing Bretonnia this time, switching it up here. Bretonnia being played by who? What is his name? Iron General, bringing Loan Leonke up in the air, just the same as our opposing player did just the game before. In the meantime, for the cavalry forces, pretty much exactly the same as well. A little bit different in the sense, though, that instead of getting three Grail Knights, or two Knights of the Realm and two Grail Knights, it looks like Iron General here has decided to bring three units of Grail Knights and only one unit of Knights of the Realm. Oh, thanks, Rogue Token. Let me take that off right now. Thank you very much for that notification. I will do so now. Clyke, I have done so. I have done so, man. Also, strangely enough, for the Bretonnians here, kind of what you were talking about, man. Mounted, was it you or was it Jacek TV?
Yeah,
mounted yeoman. Four units of mounted yeoman. This is a very interesting choice. I don't believe in them, but you do, so we'll see how they perform. For the infantry units, he's got two units of halberdiers, two units of men-at-arms with polearms here, as well as a kind of major backline of five units of spearmen at arms with their shields. What do you got here, man? What do you got for the vampire counts?
For vampires, we see the Manfred von Karstein on horseback. We see two Felbats as well, so not a lot of air. Again, very fortunate for Iron General, because he has nothing outside Lewin. Yes, he can somewhat support with the mounted yeoman archers, but they won't do that well at supporting. But anyway, other than that, we see, looks like, is it four Crypt Horrors? So yeah, the standard four Crypt Horrors with like four Cane Wraiths as well and four zombies in front of them. We see one Blood Knight on each of the flanks. So this is possibly the most standard VC build that you will see.
Yeah, I think it is, man. I think you're quite right. This is the new standard, man. You know, a couple Blood Knights on the flanks, you know, the zombies blocking up for the Karen Rays and the Crypt Horrors. Yeah, this is very, very standard. I think you're quite right there. And Butt Pomies, don't believe a mounted yeoman. Yeah, man, I just choose not to believe. I have an alternate belief system. Meanwhile, the Felbats here trying to probably catch out some of these mounted yeomen. Mounted yeomen going to do just marginal amounts of damage to the zombie infantry over there. Loenker getting involved in the battle. Probably shouldn't do that. Going to try to get out of the fight as the Felbats get into it. It's going to have to get out of there relatively rapidly, though, because the Blood Knights will do a huge amount of damage on Loen if they do manage to catch him. Also, a Spirit Leech going off on Loen. Everything going off on Loen now. Everybody excited. They want to say hi to Loen. How are you doing?
I wonder if that Spirit Leech is going to be wasted or not, because Lewin might get... He's going to get out of there, and then he's just going to regen that loss of HP.
Absolutely. I don't think Spirit Leech is worth it on Lewin anymore. Especially with the Spirit Leech nerf, I do not think it is worth it. So we see a slight micro mistake here being played out by Sephia Zeladi. Instead of charging his Fel Bats into the Grail Knights first and then allowing his Blood Knights to charge in, he actually charges all of them in at the same time. So that actually doesn't stop the charge of the Grail Knights. And so the Blood Knights take the brunt of that attack, a huge amount of damage there. Fate Abino, of course, going down to the Grail Knights, is going to chop them down to size and only leave one unit of Grail Knights remaining. But that one unit of Grail Knights can still do a good trick on the Blood Knight forces there. Meanwhile, what is going on here on the right-hand flank?
We see the engagement on the Bretonian infantry line, so the Bretonian infantry line is going to go bye-bye soon enough because because they're engaged by Cane Wraiths and Cripplers. Though we do have a nice Grail Knight charge straight into Cane Wraiths and some Cryptors, which is going to do a lot of damage, but another Knights of the Realm charge over here as well. Going to stop those units, but that Knights of the Realm unit is going to go down rapidly soon enough as well. Ooh, Blood Knights hitting the Spearmen at Arms. That's not the target that you want to hit right here. They're going to pull
certainly,
out of there.
Certainly not a great target, but it does look like these Blood Knights here, with the help of Manfred and the Karen Rays, have been able to clean up the Grail Knights here that were brought by Iron General, which does mean that without that kind of cavalry mobility in the way of those Grail Knights, that really strong cavalry mobility, he will struggle against the Blood Knights. He will struggle to kill the Blood Knights. He does have one unit, almost full health, of Grail Knights left that he can maybe try to take out the last dregs of these Blood Knights left. But of course, the Blood Knights still have relatively high unit sizes here, so it remains to be seen whether or not he'll be able to do it. The Vampire General also being taken down here in the center, a misplay by Saphir the Lady. Manfred dying, not a good idea. We have seen
alive.
What happens. Manfred is alive?
Yeah, no, he's alive.
Where the hell is that guy?
He's right there.
Oh, he is right there. What the hell just died? Did a hero just die?
I'm not sure what died anyway, but that's not Manfred.
All right, so Manfred's still alive. Good things, actually. Yeah. So, I mean, totally wrong there. My bad guy's miscasted. And
miscasted.
Miscasted right there, man. Lost half my caster dignity. in that to damage, but somebody died. Somebody important did die. In the meantime, the Vampire Count's able to crash through the lines here. Again, Peasants not very effective for holding the line. If you want somebody to hold the line, Peasants will only do it for a very short period of time. Low-end Leonko trying to do as much damage as he can to both the Cryptors and the Zombies and the Karen Rays over on this side, maybe just to make a little bit of a difference here. But unfortunately, Loenka also getting absolutely shredded by that combination of units, not doing very well. The Cryptors doing a huge amount of damage to Loenka.
Get out of there, Loenka. Or you'll die. He's
absolutely. He has heard your words, TVP. He has heard you and has listened. He's deciding to get out of there as fast as he possibly can. In the meantime, the rest of the Vampire Count's just cleaning up the last of the Bretonian infantry on the field. Some routing knights coming back, looking to get back into the fight, looking to do a little bit more damage. But it does look kind of dicey here for the Bretonians, man. I mean, what do they have going for them at this point?
So they have the mounted yeoman archers, but they're getting chased by Blood Knights. However, eventually the mounted yeoman archers can kill off these cav units, except they're getting caught, which isn't great. One of them is going to be routed off the field, because look, right now it's next to the red line, so exactly, it's just going to route off the field.
Just going to route off the field, absolutely. So another thing that let's take a look at this unit card here, guys. Look at this. In just about two, maybe three volleys of these mounted yeomen, by the way, who do pitiful, absolutely fucking pitiful amounts of damage, they've managed to knock down a goodly portion of health on these Blood Knights. So you can kind of see the effectiveness of missile troops against Blood Knights. It's kind of weird, actually. You would never see the same case with Demigriff Knights if that were the battle that we were seeing here.
Oh, and Lewin is actually engaged here, and he's dead. He's dead. He's going to get taken out here.
Oh, man, that is not good. Yeah, Lewin is shattered. That is going to be the end of it for the Bretonians there. So Saphir, the ladies champion, actually taking it, beating the Vampire Counts with the Bretonians, and then coming right back around and showing us how to play Vampire Counts against the Bretonians. Not bad. So do you think this win was largely due to, I guess, the benefits or the things that Saphir brought to battle, or largely the kind of mistakes Iron General made in Iron Army composition to micro?
Okay, so what I'll say is that even though Saphir brought, like, one of the best builds or lists or however you want to call it.
Sure.
Even though he did that, he played it exceptionally well. Besides the... Like, he did one weird thing with the Blood Knights in the beginning, but other than that, he played it out really well. Like, the engagements with the Zombies, with the Crypt Horror support and Cane Raids, that went really well for him. So, he timed it correctly. So, I'd say that he did deserve this win.
Yeah, I think he did too. I mean, I think some of the chat has mentioned this as well, and I will mention it too. Saphir made one major mistake. I'm going to say that Saphir probably won this battle due to probably two things in general. A, I think it was the mounted yeomen were not very useful for Iron General. And so that, you know, that gave kind of Saphir as a ladies champion a lot of kind of free points, so to speak, where he had extra, like, just troops that mattered to throw up against Iron General. Also, I think that, you know, he did a very, very well with his Blood Knights in the sense that, yeah, he made a mistake, right? This is the mistake that I wanted to talk about. He made a mistake by charging them straight into the Grail Knights, by charging them straight into the mass of cavalry that Bretonnia had right there. And most of the time, the Blood Knights would have lost that fight. They would have lost that fight handily. But what did we see Saphir do? And I think I've talked about this a little bit before. You know, Saphir knows how to pick his engagements, and he knows how to add things to engagements just enough so they'll turn the fights in his favor. So what did he do? He pulled one unit of Karen Rays off the line, and he pulled Manfred off the line. Just with those two extra units, he manages to beat down the entire cavalry force of the Bretonnians and also keep the majority of his Blood Knights alive.
Yeah, I mean, it was funny because at first it was a mistake, but he turned the mistake into an advantage.
Exactly. Because he trapped the Grail Knights. Exactly. It was a mistake. The charge was not the charge he should have taken. But then after he knew that he took the bad charge, he knew that he had to take his Karen Rays off the line fighting the foot troops and getting into that battle against the Grail Knights. It's a risky proposition, but it worked out for him. It gave him just enough to take care of that battle.
Yeah, and I don't know. Like, Iron General's built, I don't like it because he doesn't go one way or the other. If you bring mounted yeoman archers, I don't think you should bring like melee infantry. Or okay, at least if you do, just put all of your infantry all the way at the back, because when you have mounted yeoman archers, you have to fire with them the whole game to make them efficient.
Absolutely. Yeah. And how much ammo did they have at the end? They still had half ammo, yeah?
Yeah, they had like 10 shots each or something, at least, so still could have done some damage. So again, I didn't like his build, or at least the way he used it.
Yeah.
Like, he should have delayed the engagement more.
Yeah, and I think you're quite right again in that. I mean, even I would have even taken the regular mounted yeoman as opposed to the mounted archers for the way that he might have wanted to use them. Again, like you said, he didn't get to fire the whole game, and it probably would have been more useful just to get those shitty rear charges in with the regular mounted yeoman than it would have been to kind of go halvesies on like the land plus cavalry force and the mounted yeoman thing not really being particularly effective. Also, guys, I will be, once again, right back. You know, that classic bio break.
Oh, yes.
Let me see here. Let me get this. Let me...